Now, up until this point, we've only built apps that display an image or a layout, but we haven't yet built anything that has any functionality. That's what we're going to do in this module. And by the end, we'll build a beautiful dice app where we can hit the roll button to be able to change the dice faces randomly. So if you're ever on the move and you need to settle a score with somebody or bet on something or play a board game, this will be the app that you'll reach for in your pocket. So how do we go from a display-only app where we're displaying a design to something that has user interaction? How can we have an app where there's a button and we detect when a user actually taps on the button to translate that action into some sort of change in the app? Say changing the background color or some sort of property of a user interface element on the screen. Well, that's exactly what we're going to tackle in this module. And in the process, we're going to look at all of these things. We're going to see how we can clone an existing project from GitHub so we can learn and use one of the most useful tools that developers rely on, which is GitHub. And then we're going to spend some time designing our user interface of the Dicee app, as well as learning how to change the UI elements such as buttons or images programmatically using code, as well as detecting when a user interacts with those UI elements and respond to it with our code. Finally, we're going to learn some new Swift concepts. So we're going to talk about variables, constants, arrays, printing, commenting, and a whole lot more of Swift theory. And finally, we're going to talk about randomization, how it works, and how we can use it to create our random dice faces. For all of that and more, head into this module and we'll get started straight away.